Lucic. Caberle moves in front, shows all kinds of patience. Krejci spins, turns. It's off the glove of Mason. Shot by Lucic. And Mason sharp again. They've got to create some offense, and that's going to happen here. But six shots, and now a breakaway for Kovalchuk. Moves in, denied. The save made by Mason as Kovalchuk looked five-hole.
And this could be exactly what the Jackets need right now. You need a little bit of a spark. If you're not going to create any offense on your own, then you hope you can either get a big hit or, in this case, a better save.
Nash on that right wing board. Defending is Talinder. Oh, good hit there by Voracek. On the double behind the net, and checking that number there was Josephson.
Draw one by the Wild. Oh boy, that one almost ended up in the net, and it does! Antoine Vermette with the overtime game-winning goal. The Jackets avoid a shootout and win this one on a terrible miscue by the Wild defense.
And I'm going to quote Rick Nash, open nets, it is tough if you do not get fortuitous bounces. Chances are there, we're just not getting that bounce. But right there, the bounce come the Jackets' way. They're able to walk away with an overtime win.
Into his own zone and now off to the bench.
And that's why he leads the National Hockey League in hits.
Here, a shot by Nash and he scores! Well, so much for the goalless drought. This afternoon here in Minnesota, Rick Nash pulls the trigger, beats Backstrom, and the Jackets have the all-important 1-0 lead.
Well, when it doesn't come natural, you've got to have some help from others to help manufacture your goals. But look at where Rick Nash gets a hold of that puck in that slot area, and he has got nothing but the goaltender in the net, finds a little space on the low glove, and the Jackets have taken a 1-0 lead.